What you know about going out headrest to the real sweet beat, all up in the headrest, trying to live it up, so we ready to live it up, so it's up, so, hey, live it up. Oh, what you got to say? Oh, what you got to say? Go back Thursday, huh? Hollywood Springhead. What y'all know about that real shit? Dinky Barber, what's good? Armando, what's good? Hollywood Springhead. It's a rocker, much finer vodka. Oh shit, Living Legends from night. Throwback Thursday. It's the biggest. What you want me to do, man? Shout out the kids. I need all the info on the kids. All right. You good. Hold up. Cool from Cooling the Gang tonight, Throwback Thursday, Superior Living Legend, Legendary Group. The people don't want to work. They just don't. They got that, the unemployment is paying them more than their employee would pay them. So now, I went to a restaurant I normally go to in New York. Shout out to Venice in the Bronx, South Bronx. They can't open the restaurant because the girl's saying only her and her sister are the only employees in the whole restaurant that nobody want to work. Dan, I need that exact information real right now about the school we went to today with the kids. No, we're doing it every day.
Okay, no problem.
And so, shout out. Yo, get the fuck back to work. Don't think I'm fucking up the lick. Like, y'all got to go to work. I got a restaurant I go over here, Conde. They close down at 5 o'clock. I've been going there for years for my churrasco. The steak on the grill. Poppy be doing the steaks. He got a face only a mother could love. You know he's Cock Diesel, but he got a face only a mother could love. And so, nobody want to fucking work. And so, the famous restaurant in the Bronx, I would say, let me just say, one of the best Italian restaurants, but this is in the hood, Venice. They only got two girls working the whole fucking restaurant. They can't open the restaurant. They could only do takeout. Food was amazing. Everybody ate great. They gave us too much bread. I didn't eat none. I still carb free. You seen that movie? I ate some clams. I ate my shrimp. That's it. Carb free. Okay. So, but they was eating that crazy. You had a piece, man. That bread hitting, right? I know that bread. That's the garlic bread with the cheese on top. Cheesy. Anybody from the Bronx, if you know Venice, legendary restaurant, but they don't want to work. And so today, shout out to Mama Khaled, DJ Khaled's wife. So she got at me and was like, yo, these little kids, her brother's a school teacher. She's like, kids in the Bronx, they're about to build a school on their playground. So it's a junior high school and they have a playground in the middle of near Fordham Road. 184th, 183rd. This is a legendary park. I play pickup football games there myself. You know, and they want to take the park away and build a new school there for overcrowding. But because of COVID, kids ain't really been going there. So it ain't no overcrowding. Right? So they want to, it's bad enough the Bronx have an epidemic of juvenile diabetes and asthma. New York itself, it has no greenery. It's just a concrete jungle. So these kids are protesting, save Mike Park, save Mike Park. And so We did a protest. I came down. I brought Bronx Borough President Ruben Diaz Jr. with me. A bunch of politicians heard. They came down. The kids was out there deep. Ask Uncle Dan so I can get the right address, the right school. Please, this is very important. So I'm going to stop being stupid. And so, I turn around. Just tell me, give me the name of the school and everything so I can have the correct information. So I fly in from Miami. I stand out there in the sun with the Bronx kids in unity, unified. And because MS-363 on 184th Street, the school is MS-363, great school, principal great. But the construction department is trying to build the school on the only plot that's on the only park that's around there. The basketball courts, the park. Where are these kids supposed to exercise? So I come out there with them. And I say, you know what, man? And so while I'm there, standing out there with them, not minding my business, supporting the kids, couple of activists got on before, and I felt like they was taking shots at me. Oh, these guys only come around when it's this. I'm like, wait a minute. Are you killing the messenger? Like, you know, these kids got in touch with me, and I made the shit happen. Like, all the politicians, now they debating, now they trying to come up with a plan. I'm like, Jesus, I can't be getting shot up when I'm with you. Very different. These kids want they park, but that was almost like I tell you, I ran into the Black Lives Matter rally out here, and the kids was like, oh, you with us? I'm like, yo, bro, you trying to shoot the wrong guy. Like, I'm with you. When I tell you they trying to save the from the Underground Railroad here in Harlem. So, listen, when you got people fighting with you on your side, don't shoot at them. Don't throw shots. So I had to get on there and say, yo, I'm not a politician. Kids hit me up. I came. And I brought every politician in the Bronx with me. How can we fix the situation? I am not a politician, but I stand side by side in solidarity, in unity with the school kids of MS-363. Shout out to Lewis, a student, eloquent speaker, told us his true passion about the schoolyard. You know, this is a community thing. It's neighborhood. This ain't just the school. On Saturdays, you play football there. You there with the family. You do a cookout. You do a thing. Come on, man. And so Bronx, New York City, we could do better for these kids. We could do better for these kids. And tomorrow, Eric Adams, who's going for mayor in New York City, comes on tomorrow with us. I'm going to ask him, if he's mayor, can he help these kids? And that's what I do. I speak up for the voiceless. I'm not a politician. Right, let me see if I can find... shout out, Fernando Cabrera was there. Councilman Victor Pachado, Eureka Tapia. You know, everybody was there, right? Ruben Diaz Jr., Bronx Borough President. There'll never be another one like him. And no shots at nobody. Hold up. Let me find my brother from Cool and the Gang. He should have been on that request already. But you got to understand, these guys are beyond living legends. Quest. And so, yeah, I'm for the people, man. I'm blessed. I'm really, really, really blessed. Like, cool. I know I sent a message out to them. I'm waiting for them to accept. But I'm for the people, man. You know, I'm blessed. I'm too blessed. I can eat whatever I want. My family lives in a beautiful place. I have a couple of dollars. So I always think about my community and the less fortunate. So I came out there with the kids. And let's make it happen. Look, somebody said, listen, I'm only interviewing Eric Adams. And most likely he's going to be the mayor of New York City. Yeah, I know I endorsed Isaac Wright Jr. Right? Just because of principle. Isaac Wright Jr. definitely doesn't look like he's winning yet. But I don't know. He's not going to win. But Eric Adams looks like he's in a good position to win. He'll come tomorrow. We'll talk about the kids. We'll talk about everything. So, you know, it is what it is. He wants to bring back stop and frisk. I don't know if that's true. We'll ask him tomorrow. What I do know is a lot of people getting killed, not just in New York, but in Miami, everywhere. It is not feeling safe these days, nowhere. Hold on. Let me see if I keep sending requests. Guys, tell his son to send me the request or something, because I'm sending a request. I know I promised the living legend, a.k.a. Let me see. I promised the living legend, a.k.a. Cool from Cool in the Gang. Your Fat Joe will never be a politician in his life. I'll come and lend a voice to the people, but never a politician in my life. I can't do that. They talk to you crazy. I went there to support, and they was talking to me crazy. Every time I walk around the Bronx with Ruben Diaz, if I have dinner with him, some random guy calls him out and screams, and nah. I like money. I like my private life. That's what I do. You know what I'm saying? Damn, boy, you got that, huh? I know, but that's old school news, right?
Yeah, that's 20 years.
That's not even, that's when you broke the ice.
Yeah.
That was like you made a move. You know, yo, Rashad, what's up, man? We got Cool from Cool in the Gang. I keep sending. I'm saying that. Nigga here. You know, some guys live a life, guys. Some guys live a life. And so, like I told you, God, people, we cannot get all the way back if we don't work. I get it. They're giving you more money, unemployment. I get it. But everywhere we want to go, we can't get the food. We can't get nothing. Nobody want to work. It's two ladies working in Venice talking about, yo, just me and my sister. We work 12 hours a day. Nobody want to work. I never heard no shit like this. Even the hardworking people don't want to work. You know, people who work hard, yo, we got the game up there? Nothing. Oh, no. Put it on. Come on, Papito. We pay so much money for this shit. Yo, listen. Tell Rich Player. He's out? Where's he at? Nah. Yo, he hit him up and tell him. I'm trying to get Cool in the Gang. Le Cool Grand. L-E-K-O-O-L Grand Crew. I keep hitting you up so we can get Cool in there. You know what I'm saying? The truth. I'm all about everybody getting a step up. I'm all about people, I know the struggle. I know it's real. But all I can say is, yeah, but I can't, I keep requesting him, or he got to request me.
Yeah. No, I don't bet. You bet? I don't know. I'm not a gambler.
The Nets.
Oh,
they went crazy.
Happy Father's Day to everybody. It's coming up. Happy Father's Day. It's coming up. I keep sending that request. Somebody help me. If you see Cool from Cool in the Gang, let me know if it's a different, because the one I got is, yo, Swiss, zone, zone, zone. What's up, Swiss? The one I got is the Invisible Train is real. Is LEKOOL Grand Crew. And I keep sending out the requests. Oh, national holiday, Juneteenth. Okay? Juneteenth. Yeah, I'm trying, Rashad, to get him, but I don't know. I mean, me and this guy have been going back and forth for like, not even this guy. Let me not talk lightly. This is the living legend, you know. This is the, let me talk properly about this guy. Fat Joe's nowhere near these guys. These guys are beyond icons. These are the living legends of all living legends. Like, I'm not trying to act like we on the same level. So let me not talk lightly about this brother in no way, because this guy's big. New federal holiday. And so Juneteenth, meaning they freed the slaves, but some slaves ain't even know to 2 years after, to Juneteenth. That is crazy. Could you imagine being a slave 2 years more than you have to? Yo, where is these people at?
It keeps expiring. I was outside trying to hit them.
Oh, so that's where you was at. Could you tell them, do they got another Instagram I can hit them or something?
He said he's going to keep doing it. Hold on, let me see.
The people here for it, though. Like, they want to see it. Let me tell you something. The Greek the Freak, I've been a big fan. But he shit at the money the other day when he bobbled the ball. Yeah. Now, Kevin Durant, I seen him at the Rucker give them 81 points, and it still was a quarter to go. Kevin Durant is a god in basketball. There's no way around it. But Greek the Freak, he shit at the money. He buckled. He buckled. What's good, y'all? It's the realest in the game. Yo, what's up, Hovain? My man called me up the other day and said, yo, what you doing? I said, I'm just staying the realest.
He said, sees the request, he hits yes, and it keeps expiring.
Well, tell him to send a request to us. So I'm the opposite. Send a request to us, because the people really want to hear from Cool from Cool in the Gang. He's a living legend. We got questions about JT. We got questions about them switching from the sunk, from the soul and the funk to the disco. We got questions. Who sampled their music the best? We got questions. The people want to know. The show is based off real hip hop. Yeah, that's hard. Nah, the guy's amazing. The guy, Kevin Durant, is amazing. Hey, I heard a rumor while I was in the streets today. I kind of heard it firsthand, but I heard the rumor through the streets. But there's a rumor. Zion and his family love New York. Zion and his family said today they love New York. That's it. That's all I'm saying. Man, that's crazy we can't find them.
I told him to send a request.
I keep trying, man.
No, I told him to send you one.
I really want to get him on, man. He's a living legend, man.
The Bill Cosby.
Hideaki, James Harden. Bill Cosby. AK, we're going to call that boy 100K, huh? That boy, that boy got a 100K. What did he say? He's stopping the bank. Harden to pay, huh? He ain't got a problem with it. Harden ain't got a problem with paying. I mean, you know, one time I was with a basketball player many years ago. I was having dinner with a basketball team. And I won't tell you who, I won't tell you the team. I know Either you want to hear shit you never hear, or, you know, you saying I'm dry snitching. But it was a basketball. All of them were basketball players. And one of them was like, yo, I get $250,000 a game. Every time he plays, he gets $250,000. So he said, I got like 10 girls in 10 cities with condos. Is that tricking? Because it's not even a game to me to have the baddest chick in every city. I said, well, you know, to me it sounds tricking. You tricking, and then you on top of the apartment, what you got to buy in bags and all that shit. It sounded to me like you tricking. But he was trying to tell me, yo, listen, I make $250,000 a game. You know, like it's not even a game for me to have all these. Yo, crazy, man. I mean, you had to think different when you heard that. Bill Cosby. Yo, Bill Cosby better take them programs if he wants to come home. You know, he's refusing to take the Predator programs. O.J. Simpson said he did all the programs. He did all the programs. Yo, Rashad, what's up? That's the key. Quebec is in the building. Tell me who's tuned in till I get LaCool. Tell me where you from. So we can show these people. Well, Santo Domingo's the first one. It's not tricking if you have it, he said. Some of you guys are tricks, though. It's not tricking if you got it, but some of you guys are tricks. Like, bad. You bad for business in the guy code. You bad for business. All right, it's your wife. It's your wife. You've been with her for years. Okay, get her whatever the fuck you want. You just meeting joints, tricking the bag. You're a trick. Mr. Robert Cool Bell. Let's try that.
Yes.
What, you telling me that now?
No, I'm saying let's try it. I'm not telling you anything.
Mr. Robert Cool Bell. Any of you guys know Rich Player the God? He has a very short temper, and he suffered too many hits on the football field. So it's not PTSD, it's CTE. A.K.A. don't fuck with him too much because he will curse you the fuck out anywhere. Puzzle Life was good. Yeah, yo, Rashad, you used Ladies Night for Little Kim, huh? Shout out to Wynwood in the building. Jesse Keg, what's up? Canada in the building. They say, yes, we love Rich. Football Rich, a.k.a.
Don't play him, son.
A.k.a. you're not in the car with him all day hearing him curse out old ladies. Old men, like, he's got the biggest case of road rage in the universe.
Anybody can get it.
Anybody can get it.
Even you.
Even me. I get it.
And not you. I'm talking about you. That's the same.
Hold up, Mr. Robert. We're going to try that one again. Damn, man. Trying Mr. Robert Cool Bell, the Cool Grand Crew. I'm trying everything, man. This is sad because I really, really want to talk to this guy. Shout out to my brother, Diamond D. All the producers are tuned in for this. All the producers, Rashad, formerly Tumbling Dice. No, I'm not a Latin King. I've never been a Latin King.
We're not gang members.
I've never been a gang member. Of any gang in my life. Never been a gang member. I get it. People different ways. You know, what I was talking about out there, somebody came up to me. You know, I think Fat Joe could do anything, right? I don't know if y'all know that. I'm just a rapper. And so, it came up to me, the brother was like, yo, you know, I did 10 years in the feds and I'm talking to all the gangs and I'm trying to get everybody to stop killing each other. And I'm like, He's like, I really need you. And I'm like, well, what do you want me to do? And so, by talking to him and talking to people and getting into the discussion, it sounded like a lot of it got to do with some of these kids don't have fathers in their lives, either in their life or raised them. Maybe they in jail, maybe their father used drugs, whatever, or dead. But a major issue is they ain't got their fathers. And so you know, that's really, really, it's really, really sad, but we got to work through that. And so the big brothers that they love, that you're messengers, you might have been a former gang member, you know, that people respect you, you're authentic. We got to become the new fathers if they fatherless and talk to them and talk them off the ledge. There's a real epidemic going on out there with people killing each other. They say he's here, Joe. I don't know what to tell you. I have sent 1 million requests. I'm going Robert Cool is in the building. I know, guys, I keep sending. All right, you know what I do? I'm going to turn off the whole thing and turn it back on. Maybe we'll get him again like that. Let's do that.